All right, and we're recording. Hey gang, Andy here, and welcome to my December 2017 update video for, you guessed it, December 2017. Woo! So yeah, as always with my monthly update videos, I'm going to be going over some personal life stuff as well as YouTube-y stuff. And this month, they both sort of intermingle with each other, so there's not really going to be as clear-cut of a this is my YouTube-y stuff, and this is my personal life stuff sort of thing like I normally do with these. So, with that said, guys, let's get right into it. And let's start off with the elephant in the room, the fact that I haven't been uploading that many videos on my YouTube channel. Now, I know some of you may be a little concerned about that. Oh, he's quitting YouTube. Or if you've been reading about my mental health problems, you know, maybe you think there's something a bit darker behind the reason why I'm not uploading as much. Not gonna lie, a little bit has to do with the mental health stuff, but the main reason behind my lack of uploads recently is a bit more positive. As you guys know, I am the main editor for my good old buddy, TKO Sam, on his channel. I edit the TKO Rants, TKO Reacts, and most recently, his TKO Cinema series on his channel, in addition to other little videos that he commissions me to do. So those have been picking up quite a lot for this coming month. So I've been really busy getting a lot of stuff out for that. I'm also picking up a couple more video editing gigs for some other people. Been pretty busy with that, working on a lot of YouTube videos. So my brain is pretty frazzled with that. In addition to, you know, other personal life stuff, school, wrapping up. Things have been pretty busy on my end. Mental health-wise, it's been kind of hit or miss for me. You know, I've had some victories, but I've also had some defeats. It's a continuing learning process, you know, dealing with mental health and, you know, anxiety, depression, all this kind of stuff. You know, I'm not just gonna wake up one day and be like, haha, I have it solved, and I'll never suffer anxiety or depression again, haha. You know, the only thing I can do is just chip away at it bit by bit, get a little bit better every day, and I feel like I'm doing that. And one of the main things, as I've explained in the previous video, that I've been doing is changing my wake-up patterns. So I used to wake up around 9, 10-ish at the earliest, and those are only on days where I would actually go to class. But I've been doing it a lot more consistently, been doing it daily actually. I think the latest I would wake up would be like 9 o'clock in the morning. I've been trying to wake up with the sun, basically. So, you know, when the sunrise happens, that's usually when I try to wake myself up. So around 8 o'clock when the sun rises. School-wise, you know, things haven't really been going so well for me. And I think one of the main reasons behind that is just the area. Nothing against Kalamazoo, Michigan. I mean, for a lot of people, this is a really fun, enjoyable place. And, you know, good on you if you're from the area or living in the area and you like it. But for me, it's just not where I need to be. During one of my anxiety, depressive low points, I really examined just some things in my life that I'm not really happy about. Now, the apartment, the rent and everything is pretty cheap. I'm able to really get my cost of living down to a very small amount, so that's good. But as far as just life enjoyment, it's not really all that good. It's kind of hit or miss. One of the things that I'm looking to improve upon is my own satisfaction with life. And, you know, noticing a lot of the trends and stuff that I've been doing or not doing, including posting a lot of like old pictures on my Instagram. I enjoy those photos, I think they're nice, but when all I have to offer is photos from like 2, 3, 4, 5 years ago, it just really weighs down on me and shows that I feel like I've put my life on pause in a way, moving up here to try to go to school and everything. You know, I lost out on a key component to success, which is surrounding yourself with other people. You know, being in the military for 5 years, constantly having, you know, people around you all the time, I initially just wanted a break from all that and just kind of wanted to do my own thing. You know, having been out of the military for over 2 years now, on my own, by myself, it's kind of lost its luster after a while, so I'm looking to make some new connections and to network and to really put myself out there. Speaking of Instagram, if you don't know or aren't following me, Instagram.com/TheAndySan, I made the announcement on there first, but I want to officially make it here on YouTube. In 2018, my main goal is to move out to Los Angeles. And I know that's a really big goal, And I'm going to get a lot of responses of like, hey, Andy, congrats on finally making the move. You know, you're doing good things and stuff like that. But I'm also going to get a lot of people saying, you shouldn't really do that. You should just like get a full-time job, grow the fuck up. You're 32 years old. Oh, by the way, I had a birthday this past week on December 7th. So 32, what you going to do? Regardless of all that, I'm going to be moving out to LA in 2018. Now, I've also done a lot of work in getting myself set up over there. I've been contacting some colleges out there, get myself started, and you know, things are definitely looking up. So now it's all a matter of just saving up the money to move out to LA. Once I go out and transfer to college out there, I'll be able to collect on the GI Bill, so I'll be able to continue to make some money out there while also working on some part-time hustling gigs, continuing my video editing for Sam and others, and just build myself up that way. But I have to be where the action is, and that's ultimately the reason why I want to move out to LA. Now, don't get me wrong, I do love Japan. I know I've been saying that I want to move out to Japan once I graduate and all that kind of stuff, but I really took a long, hard look at myself and realized that as much as I love Japan, me being there isn't going to get me to where I need to be career-wise. It's definitely a possibility, a very strong possibility, that I'd be coming back to Japan, whether it's to visit or maybe for a year or two sabbatical, but I don't want to make any plans about that just yet. So I see that my camera is getting pretty hot, so I think we'll end things here. If I miss anything, I'll probably just make a part deux to this video. So, with that said, guys, this is the Andy-san, signing for now, and as always, we'll see you next time. Catch you later, guys. Bye.